to here with two-way mirrors. So we just had some technical difficulties, so we're redoing the live video. So today I'm going to talk about infinity mirrors and how you can use different mirrors to get different effects. So first up, I'm just going to go around the room and show everyone what we have put together ready to go. First we have the infinity beer pong table. So that's this big thing right here. It's featuring a glass two-way mirror, tempered, because it's a table. If it's not tempered, that means when you would place a glass on it or anything like that, it could break potentially. So tempering does cause a little bit of distortion around the perimeter, but for infinity mirror projects, it's usually not a big deal. And then on the bottom of the infinity mirror here, we have an acrylic standard mirror. So notice on the beer pong table, there's a bit of a gap between each LED strip in reflection when it goes to infinity. And that's strictly because of the standard mirror, which just means the mirror coating is on the back. So sometimes you can use a first surface mirror to get a different effect. So come over here to the chess set. So the chess set has a glass smart mirror. And then on the back, there's a first surface mirror. So there's literally no gap here between each LED strip's reflection as it goes to infinity. And I also have a first surface here, so you can check that out. So on this side, it is a standard mirror. And then on the back, it's got the blue coating. So that is what protects the first surface side. I'm just gonna put that down. And then use the one we've already peeled. So on the first surface side, there's no gap between your finger and its reflection. Perfect. So I'm just gonna back it up a bit. So traditionally in an infinity mirror setup, you have the glass two-way mirror, which is actually one directional in our case. So you'd place the mirror coated side to face the other mirror that it's reflecting against. That way, when you peer into the beer pong table, for instance, you're not getting as much of your reflection as you are able to just see the infinity effect in a more deep way. And then with the glass smart mirror, it can be installed in either direction, so when you're looking at it from above, you do see a reflection of yourself and the infinity at the same time, more so. All right, so we've got the beer pong table, the chess set, and this is an infinity cube created with five glass smart mirrors put together along with a first surface on the bottom, so you can create that infinity effect in more than one way. So we've taken the traditional infinity setup and made it more into a cube, a three-dimensional object. All right, next up we have our Dungeon Master. So this could be super great for, you know, events. If you're doing a Dungeons and Dragons and you're the Dungeon Master and suddenly you're at the table, you've got to decide, all right, what am I going to do next to, like, shake things up? Suddenly, a monster comes through the portal, and it's like waving its magic wand, like, oh my god! And then suddenly, you ask all of the other people in the room, what am I gonna do? What are you guys gonna do to combat this? It can be a really awesome prop for games, or to just like set up somewhere. But yeah, so this actually features an acrylic two-way with a first surface or a standard mirror in the back. But instead of LED strips going around, it just has two lights. And yeah, so we have that, the Dungeon Master. Next up we have a star. So you can do all different shapes with acrylic or glass. We can't do the custom shapes for the acrylic, but you can easily, you know, cut that on your own. So with the acrylic, it does have a more bendy nature, and there is a laminate here that I'm going to peel off. So let's see. Oh man. Oh yeah, so this side will be the easiest to peel. So the laminate here is just protecting the mirror surface. And we're just gonna take that off. Whoa, it's really stuck on there. Oh man. Oh. So actually with this star, the bendiness kind of works to its advantage because you can kind of twist and turn the lights a bit so it gives like a really interesting effect. Sure, it was supposed to be pulled off quite like that, but there you go. So this is what the Star Affinity mirror looks like. So it's battery operated, so you can literally put this anywhere, take it with you on field trips, road trips, pretty much anywhere you want. All right, so last up here we have a DIY project. So they sent it to us with 4 acrylic two-way mirrors, and then we replaced it with a dielectric and 3 first surface mirrors. So in this particular setup, what they did is they made this from scratch, and they were teaching the students how to, the different effects, the different two-way mirrors that are out there, what that looks like. Because I mean, growing up, I really didn't even know about two-way mirrors, so it's cool that they would teach that to the students. So you can turn it off, turn it on, and see how the batteries are connected. So it's a great little DIY project out there. All right, so now that we've checked out everything on the table, I do have a demonstration here just to have a simple setup here for an infinity mirror. So an infinity mirror is basically just 2 parallel mirrors with a light source in between. And you can use a lot of different types of mirrors to make this effect. So traditionally we have the glass two-way LED light. And then on the back, we have the first surface. Even more traditional is people using the standard mirror. So I did face it. So the standard mirror is towards the glass two-way. Cool. And notice with the glass two-way, you do want to face it so the mirror coating is toward the light. All right, so next up, we're going to check out the glass smart mirror, just in this really simple setup. It does have a bit more of a ghosting effect, but notice you can use it to create the infinity effect, and each reflection is still really crisp, and it's really color neutral. And we have our dielectric mirror. Notice how transparent that is, but it also has a nice infinity. And then last up here, we have our two-way mirror film. Usually people wouldn't use the film for a two-way infinity effect, but we do get a lot of questions about the infinity effects with the film, just because it is a nice budget option. The film can be installed in either direction for an infinity setup, so you would want to put the film so it's facing the inside so people wouldn't be able to like touch it or mess with it. But notice that the reflection here on the film is much foggy. It doesn't have that nice crisp reflection that the glass does. And then finally, before I take that out, actually, notice the gap between the lights and its reflection, because I'm going to flip over the standard mirror so you can see the first surface side. And notice how the lights are closer together. So the infinity effect is more scrunched in that case. There's really not a better or worse way to make the infinity. It's all about the aesthetic that you want when you're making your mirror. Some people actually prefer that spaced out nature so it has that deeper, like longer effect into infinity. Whereas, I don't know, at the same time, I really love how the lights are really close together. So it's really all about the aesthetic. But anyway, we do have one last prop here that I want to show off. I didn't have it running, but it's great for Halloween props or like haunted houses, and it's the haunted mirror infinity effect. So didn't leave it running for the entirety of the live feed because it would just keep going off. But the idea is you have this set it up. You have it set up on a desk or table somewhere where someone might be coming up and getting some candy, and then all of a sudden it's motion activated to activate the haunted mirror. That wraps up our live feed video with the infinity mirror effects. So please leave a comment below if you have any questions or need more information about infinity mirrors, because that's our specialty. All right, see you later.